Alright, I've done this before. I'm not sure if I put it on video. And I just did a vegan cheese with Thrive Market. So I'm going to do this and I'm going to send it in to them as well or on their YouTube or something. I don't know. I just figured it'd be good for the people that buy from them. So I had this leftover bag of chips. They're a little bit spicy. And I said, you know what? I got to cut the spice down a little bit. I know a good way. So I'll make this real simple hummus or bean dip, whatever you want to call it. And I'll use the vegan cheese again to show you. So use the chips are jalapeno lime, and I got lemon juice. I don't have any lime juice, but it won't matter. It will go good together. Use real lemon if you want. I had this on hand. I don't have any real lemons with me. It's a number one recycled container. I use these white kidney beans. They're organic, non-GMO in a can. The reason I buy them in a can is because the cans are about, they say 77%. Recycled in our country and around the world. If you buy regular beans, they come in a bag, you know, like just a flat cellophane, I guess, or whatever type plastic bag. You can't recycle them. And I mean, even if they do say you can recycle them with a number or something, you try to find a place that will actually take them or a drop-off point. So stay away from that stuff. That's the stuff that goes into the water. Watch the guys in South Africa and all around the world where they're rescuing seals and stuff, and you got plastic bags all around their neck and twisted up and all that, and all kinds of crap. So stay away from that stuff. Thrive puts this in a number one container, so that's good, because for the last, I say 2.5 years, you can't do 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 plastics by me. And when you look on the online and on YouTube and everywhere, you'll see that that's going across the board pretty much everywhere. And even if they do take it, it's ending up in landfills. So stay away from that stuff. Ones and twos, plastics, cans, and glass bottles. Don't buy any bags. Now you say, well, that's a bag. Well, this is the only chip bag I'll buy because I haven't used it yet, but it says you can do it. So this thing is called TerraCycle. Look it up online. I looked it up about 2 years ago, and if I remember correctly, you need about 2 pounds worth of bags. You print out a label from their website and you ship it or something like that to them, and they recycle it. So that's why I buy these, and I have a closet where I have them stacked in a box until I'll send them all out. So stay away from bags, even like resealable bags from cookies, rice, chips, crackers. They're not taking wax boxes anymore by me for 2.5 years either. They're taking only corrugated shipping boxes, and that's it. And again, that's going across the board. A lot of that stuff is happening like that. There are people who are still taking some of it, trying to figure out ways, but it seems like it's a problem environmentally and money-wise to do it. So stay only what you need. I'm a vegan. I'm one meal a day, and I do all this to the best of my ability, all right? So if everybody does that, if you don't buy the stuff, then they won't produce it. And then they'll get the hint, whether it's Thrive Market or the producers of bean bags and all the other stuff. They'll get the hint, and then the government will get the hint, and the EPA will get the hint. Like, all the production is going down, and nobody's buying this stuff because people are becoming more aware, more minimal, eco-friendly, and everything like that, okay? So, do your best to not buy the bags of beans, the bags of rice, the bags of this, bags of that, the boxes of this, the boxes of that. It's just no good. Learn to make your own stuff as well. All right. So that being said, this is a really quick thing. So vegan Parmesan by Thrive, and thrivemarket.com if you don't know that. My camera may not pick it up, but what it says is soy free, gluten free, cholesterol free, vegan, non-GMO, and I'm not sure what that U is. Maybe one day it will stand for universal, universally aligned and recyclable container. Here's what it's, let's see here. All right. And it's excellent. It tastes just like regular Parmesan cheese. Vegan stuff is getting better and better throughout the last decade. And that's one of the products that is really good. Vegan cheese overall is really good. Matter of fact, all right, so I'll break this out while I'm here. So this is a vegan Parmesan cheese. It's excellent on salads, soups, sauces, in your hummus and bean dips and whatever else you're making. But I also do this with it, and it's excellent. Comes out like a wet mozzarella look and feel, but a little bit maybe like with a little bit of a hardness like provolone. It's excellent. That one has fresh basil in it, and that one's normal. I'll tell you the recipe right now just in case I don't link the other video to it. And since we're talking about cheese and what to do with it, that cheese right there is exactly what this is. So what I did is, ready for this? Write it down. All right. One can, 13.5 ounces, 15 ounces, it doesn't really matter, of coconut milk or cream. Make sure you do the one that's high fat. You take one can of that, right, the cream. You throw it in your blender. You take 3 tablespoons of that, and you throw it in your blender right here, this guy. 3 tablespoons. Do not go over that. Then you do a half a cup of warm water, throw that in the blender, salt to taste, pepper if you'd like, and then 2 tablespoons of agar, all right? Blend it up till it's smooth, throw it in a small pan, a pot on your stove, put it on 5 or 6, stir it for 5 to 8 minutes, constantly whisk it, use a whisk, and bring it to a bubbling boil, not so it's all over the place, just so it's bubbling slowly like that. That activates the agar. Pull it off the stove, continue to whisk it, let it sit, pour it in molds or pour it in a Tupperware container, whatever you like. I have silicone molds that they pop right out, but I have done it in a smaller Tupperware with the leftover. You just outline it with a knife when it's solid, and then turn it over, falls right out. I'll show you real quickly here, so you can see the bounce and the wobble. It's cheese. All right, it turns out just like cheese. And that, I've done it with the cream and without it. And without it, it comes out slightly mild. With the cream, it's more of a bold cheese flavor. So that's it. That's simple. That's a great thing you can do with this as well. All right? So I just wanted to share that with you. And you could pop this in the mold after 2 to 5 minutes of cooling off the stove. And within 20 to 30 minutes, it's cold, hard, and you got cheese to slice. It melts pretty well, too, on pizzas and great in wraps and on salads, on crackers, or whatever the heck you're doing or you're making. All right, so that being said, today it's 2 cans of the beans. The lemon juice to taste, you don't see it out here, but I got sea salt to taste. And I have olive oil too, which is a non-GMO number 1 container that can be recycled as well. And the olive oil, I just put a tad in there. And so that's all you do. And then you put this into the taste you like, and you process it all up. And that's it. You got a nice cheese. Let's see here. It will take some of the heat off of this guy right here. And you could do it to whatever texture you like. Yep, good. You can put whatever you want in this. You could throw it in a bowl, dice up some diced, nice organic non-GMO tomatoes, maybe celery, whatever the heck you want. And you can make that even more gourmet like as you want. And that's what I do sometimes, roasted red bell pepper, whatever you want. Today it's just this plain and simple base for cooling down the heat of these chips. All right, it's simple, it's easy, and it's cheesy. It's simple, easy, and it's cheesy. And Thrive Market makes this, so it's really good. Another one that comes in another number 1 container, Nutrit. I don't know how it's spelled because I don't have one on hand right now. Oh, you know what? Maybe I do. All right, I had one in my recycling. So, Nutrit. Ted Nutrit. Get it? Anyway, here. That's what's in it. Now, this one's nutritional yeast. Thrive is inactive yeast. And I'm glad it's not nutritional yeast because nutritional yeast on its own doesn't really have that great of flavor. This one's pumped full of vitamins and everything. Now, this is another excellent thing, and you could put it in there. As you saw, it had a lot of garlic in it. It's very salty and very garlicky, so it works good in dips too. Now, if you take the same recipe I gave you for the block cheese, and you use this instead of that, this will still solidify, but because this is dense, and I don't know what else the word is, but it's like dense, it will come out cuttable and like a block, but it will spread. It will look and feel and taste exactly like one of those cheese rolls during Christmas time. You know, the logs or the balls that apparently I asked my mother, what kind of cheese is that? Sometimes it's port wine cheddar. Sometimes it's like a white cheddar. And that's exactly what you'll get if you use this flavor. this in the block cheese kind of comes out like that Parmigiani Swiss like mozzarella. It's really cool because I guess the coconut milk cream brings that together with that. It's really nice. This will be like a block cheese on Christmas. So you can use this in that recipe that you just wrote down a few minutes ago, but just know that when you roll it out of your mold and you cut it, you can smush it down real easy and it will spread just like a cheese. It will be exactly like that nut cheese roll on Christmas, all right? So there, you got two different cheeses with one different recipe, and then you got this as well that you can do, all right? I'm gonna leave it simple like that. Thank you very much for watching, and like I said, you can make it gourmet and do whatever you want with it. And give me some things that you guys do with it. What would you add to it? And again, when you make the block cheese, I haven't shared this with you right here. So the one you saw that had the mozzarella, you see it in the near, can you see it? The basil, fresh basil from my garden. Put roasted red bell peppers in there and then cover it up with cheese with the basil. Oh, it's so awesome. But you could do nuts in that as well. I've done dark cherries, dill, fresh parsley, whatever kind of cheese you want to make, you can do it. And you can do the same with this as well. You could really make this cheesy if you want. I left it so it has a nice cheese flavor, but it's not overpowering. You could turn it into like a real cheese flavor if you want. People wouldn't even know it's beans, really, if you didn't tell them. So that's it. I'll keep this video as short as I can. All right, lots of love to you. It's a record. It's under 30 minutes. Yay! All right, lots of love to you. Bye-bye.